Hi, my name is Alex Chesler, and I'm an investigator in the Intramural program here at the National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health. Our Intramural program here at the NIH is focused on how the brain perceives and modifies pain. The neurons we're focusing on in this study have a number of interesting features that make them uniquely suited for detecting rapid mechanical stimuli, such as when a hair is being pulled. Imagine that you're walking barefoot and you step on something sharp. You'll lift up your leg faster than you perceive the pain in sort of a reflex motion. And then slowly the pain will develop and you'll think, wow, that's really gonna hurt. And then it starts to really hurt. The neurons in this study seem to be participating in that fast reflex to mechanical pain. All of these reflexive behaviors are critically important for our survival. But you can imagine under chronic pain conditions that they become maladaptive. It sounds almost funny or trivial to study something like hair pull. I mean, you know, I didn't go into science to become a hair pull scientist. But there's a number of things that this study tells you about how the brain encodes painful information that it gives us really fundamental insights into the system that I think in the long term will be of great benefit. The fact that there are neurons that are dedicated to this rapid sensation of mechanical pain gives us a new target for treating mechanical pain. It's my belief that when we have an understanding of these basic principles of how pain is encoded by the nervous system, we could take a much more rational approach to developing better therapies. This is just one class. We still don't know how many different types of neurons there are. We don't know yet the molecules that they're using to sense these stimuli. And we've yet to identify the neural circuits in the brain that distinguish between something that is innocuous, like a gentle touch, to something painful, like a hair pull. We now have access to these neural circuits in ways that we didn't have before. So we can leverage advances in neurogenetics, in imaging, and a host of other research tools available to the lab to really probe and understand these neural circuits at a level that we haven't been able to do before.